Everything we did before is kind of, if you really take it in, is real similar to like trap hip hop from Atlanta. So we just kind of like infusing it stuff we like with our locals.
That is exactly the next question. Who do you all look up to? I mean, in terms of being an artist and locally, but you know they say Lil Wayne is Bush.
You
know,
we spent 5 hours here.
Well, I mean, you see, because I spoke to someone that does hip hop, you know, no big name, but he kept saying Lil Wayne is Bush, and I'm saying, how could he be Bush if he's the biggest thing? So I mean, in terms of hip hop artists, they say the lyrics lame and it's small, and it's kindergarten lyrics, and I don't get it.
I know it is. Like, I understand. As somebody who like takes lyrics very seriously, his lyrics is the kick sometimes now, but it's appeal to people. That's the most important thing as a musician. Like, you want to appeal to as many people as possible. If people want something, you being the best at whatever you feel is the best, don't matter, you know.
True.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
whatever they want matters.
Talks, you know, you have to give the people what they want. You have to do stuff that, you know, also reflects you. So that really reflects a little bit, you know, that's why you reach the top.
So who do you look up to? Top three artists?
Artists ever or rappers? Yeah.
Rappers.
Well, M for sure is on my list. Eminem.
Right.
Thought about. Well,
I thought Jay would be up there.
Yeah.
Jay's not my top three favorites.
Oh. He's on mine.
That's not saying I don't like Jay-Z, but my favorites. Nah, he's not on my top three.
Eminem.
Biggie for sure. I don't know who's number three, but I'd even if I could put Biggie there, to be honest. I really love Biggie. I even gonna try because I said that. If you are sorry.
Well, that is what I'm gonna
ask. There's a slight age difference between us. I'm 29 versus what?
26.
Yeah, 26. So for me, is Jay-Z, Tupac, and actually born Jamaican.
Right.
I'd say like my. And actually, I don't mention these fellas. So my biggest influence musically, I would say, is Treason.
See, wow.
Real talk. You know, I mean, I think they show me that you could be local and not sing soca and still be cool and still, you know, so big up to the Treason family.
They still together, they
I know they tried something.
They're still working on stuff together.
Yeah, but actually, when they solo
I forgot to mention, when I started in the industry, I started under their producer, Ken Holder. So I used to work with them when I was 15.
Wow, alright, cool, man. Look at them, yeah.
In terms of the hip-hop game, in terms of what you all could do to help get hip-hop out there for artists like yourself who studied, why can't do this soca, boy? Soca is not for me. Reggae is not for me. I like hip-hop, but everybody tell them, hip-hop will never go anywhere in Trinidad.
No, that's not true, man, because if you really look at our summer, we had shows literally 2-3 times a week. Wow. And then we, sometimes, you know, and then we perform in Great Fat, open for Shaba and Future. Okay. So, like, I mean, there is a spot for us. We just have to work at it and make sure our quality level is continuously high. Before we went to the break, it's asking us about our videos.
Right,
that's really important, too, now. You have to make sure your video quality is real high and it represents something as you, so people can relate to it, now. We understand that's what you need. So once everybody else comes with that same thing in a similar vein that represents themselves, hip-hop in Trinidad will be in a real good place next year if they do it.
Does this industry pay for y'all, or y'all have other jobs and this is just... It
hasn't reached a point yet where a hip-hop artist from Trinidad could earn a living from being a hip-hop artist.
Right.
That's just the honest truth.
Yeah.
But, I mean, we into social media.
You think it could go there?
Yeah. I think eventually, I think that's what we... Because I remember Bureau was asking us when we came in if we were going to dabble into soca. Mm-hmm. And our answer was no, just because we want to develop what we're doing here. We really believe in it.
Mm.
And we believe that, you know, if you think about it, from Ash Wednesday till Soca Switch is ours as non-soca artists. We actually have more time than soca artists. So we have no excuses. You know, it's up to, but we had to come together and build the industry.
Is there a fight in the hip-hop arena?
I wouldn't say a fight, but there's definitely people.
No, you use the word as it is, because they say the soca industry have a fight. Does it have the same fight in the hip-hop arena?
As in, you mean like
a bad mind people fighting, you know, somebody looking for the spot to get taken, so they fellas out
there. I
find the biggest thing I got, you know, earlier when he was asking about how people feel about Lil Wayne and lyrics.
Right.
Like, I feel like some people feel like we should really go down like a super lyrical path. But these songs we do not like that. Like, if you go make a pumping song and then happen to the hard lyrics and these songs.
It's fun
music
making, you know, it's just,
you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, but we could do that style too, you know. We could make the seriously lyrical song. We could even make clash songs. We do real dub plays for DJs and we have that side of us. But for us right now, the fun element is what we're starting with. We're easing it, and then on the album you'll hear a lot of different tracks.
So you'll have any album coming out, right?
Oh yeah, next year, TTT, Trinidad and Tobago Trap.
TTT.
Yeah.
Trinidad and Tobago Trap.
Yeah.
It's local.
Yeah.
it's a pop culture album. Educating on the diaspora, feeling what we're doing as well.
Right.
You know, when we went away, a lot of people living away just kept on saying, like, we like what you're doing. You'll actually make us homesick. And we hear pump and we're missing the avenue.
Yeah.
So not only soca could make you homesick, the music we're doing. Mm-hmm. And you know, we really feel like we're on the zone.
Mm-hmm. Well, we have 2 minutes left and I want to open it up because I'm a man I always flopping when it comes to freestyle. I'm Mr. Flop.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Mr.
Flex them proper, yeah. Them say after pumping that we care rap. So we hit them musically with a hard slap. You know we GT like signing up for Costa. Me and my team the record.
You just schooled them.
After pumping that we care up. So we hit them musically with a hard slap. You know we GT like signing up for Costa. Me and my team lyrically, yeah, we all sharp. Boozy up like supple jet. Me and Rod inside his head. Plus a gal wanna be with friend like Lata P. She's a 10. Take she home like HGC.
What are
they? Wow! Yeah, boy!
Yeah, boy.
You ready?
Yeah.
Alright, let's go. Yo. Yo. Brother. Yo, look. Yo, they call me Rudder. I knock beats out like a stone cold stunner. You hate if you wanna. Like Uncle Jack, I say, ask your mother.
Shut it off!
Hey, fellas, I must say, boy, enough respect for passing, boy. You know, a lot of time we like to test artists, eh?
Yeah.
And we've had a few who fell flat, eh?
Yeah.
Fell flat and drag on their face.
We pass the test.
Yeah. Look at you.
Right now, I'm carrying it to cut an album, boy! They keep telling me, boy!
Shout out everybody in hip-hop, you know? Y'all know who y'all are. I can't call out everybody right now, I don't have enough time, but...
No, what I need to do is I need to bring them back beer.
Yeah.
I want to get more into, you know, more into how his father feels about the music.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we all the time now, but I definitely want to bring y'all back, especially is the day before the holiday. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? But I want to bring y'all back. We'll see if we can link with y'all and link it for next week if possible.
Yeah.
And we're going to make this happen again.
Yeah.
This have to happen again.
Yeah.